One-timer sets up Marty Saint-Louis. It's in his feet. Stolen on a breakaway. Tyler Johnson in alone. Stopped by the King. And the rebound went into the net, but it's waved off immediately.
And, Jim, I think this one should be in. This one hits Marty Saint-Louis and goes in between the legs of Henrik Lundqvist. And from my view up here, before the puck went over the net, over the line.
Tyler Johnson wanted it right away. He thought it was a goal, and he's high-fiving everybody at the bench.
It did, and this isn't a case where it's the Tampa Bay player knocking a goalie in. This is Marty Saint-Louis knocking his goaltender in. Saint-Louis tries the pass, gets the one-timer into the skates and can't get it. Gets a little help from Boyle, but watch the end of the play here. It's Marty Saint-Louis who knocks his goaltender in and puts the puck in.
After a pass in his feet, handcuffed him, and Johnson took off. Killorn was wise to give Johnson the puck. They were almost 2-on-0. This would be a Samsung goal review. They'll look at this in the situation room, and I think they're going to call this a goal.
The problem is, though, they can't look at it in the situation room if the call on the ice is that it's knocking the goaltender in. That's why this discussion is going on so long before they go to the situation room.
Kelly Sutherland waved it off.
Yeah, so if he's saying that it's contact to Tampa, they can't go look at it.
But he can confer, as we've often seen this season, with the other officials on the ice and change his mind.
And if they're convincing him that it wasn't a case of a Tampa player knocking him in, and they only want to look at whether the puck went in before the net comes off, this will be a Tampa goal.
Well, this is a decision that has to be made so quickly at such a high pace of speed. Colin Campbell is in the building, so certainly not at home watching this, able to give anyone any advice to it. But you're right, Zimmer. It all depends on what Sutherland is thinking as he waves this off.
Clearly the puck is in the net before the post comes off.
And I don't know if you saw, Dan Boyle was going up to the officials and saying, well, you waved it off. Well, yeah, because the call from the official down there was a wave off, like what happens every single time. They confer, they talked, and boy, they talked for a good 2 minutes, didn't they?
At 5-on-3, you look at Brian Boyle. He would have been a guy out killing that 5-on-3.
What a break on the pass from Dan Boyle to Marty Saint-Louis that was right in his feet, and that allowed Johnson and Killorn to take off. An inauspicious start to the game for Marty Saint-Louis.
And I just can't help but say what it does to a team when you've got an early 5-on-3, you got a chance to take control of the game, and you can't get it. And how about Rick Nash again? Marty Saint-Louis hasn't scored in 16. He's back on the point. Rick Nash, his power play and playoff struggles continue.
Kelly Sutherland with the call.
Upon video review, the puck has clearly crossed the line and in the net prior to the net coming off. Therefore, we have a good goal.